Let me tell you a little story. Tiger goes to Bird's family and says, "Hey, goat is trying to harm you, but I have the means to protect you. You will just have to stay in my house until we tackle the goat. The moment the threat is neutralized, you will be free to walk out of my house." Bird agrees, despite the family's protests. The so-called threat is quickly neutralized. Bird's family now wants to go home, but Tiger does not allow. Tiger forcefully keeps Bird's family in the house. 71 years later, Bird is long dead. But the promise to its family has not been fulfilled. Not only that, Tiger's security guards start torturing Bird's family. The more they demand their freedom, more suppression and abuse they face. From rape to murder to almost blinding an infant, no one is spared. Sounds brutal? Thank goodness it's just a story. Not. This is a reality. This is India forcefully keeping Kashmir in its territory. That infant I just mentioned is an 18-month-old girl from South Kashmir's Shopian district named Hiba, who was hit by pellets by Indian armed forces. She might never get back her sight. An infant! A baby! She's the youngest victim of pellet guns, but scores of civilians have been blinded by Indian Army's usage of pellet guns just for demanding their self-determination and independence. Indian government and army have always maintained that pellet guns are used on pro-freedom protesters, that is, Kashmiris who want freedom from India. Not that it is an acceptable justification by any means, but how the hell do you justify hitting a child? Was she a threat to your national security? Was she throwing rocks at you? She was just in her mother's arms when your lead pellets pierced her right eye. How do you justify that? To answer why they justify this crazy violence, let's dive into a quick history of the conflicts in Kashmir. The genesis of the Kashmir issue can be traced back to 1947, the year India won independence from the 2-centuries-long British colonialism. The then king of Kashmir, Maharaja Hari Singh, a Hindu ruler in the Muslim-majority valley, dreamt of ruling Kashmir independently, while more than 500 princely states were banded together to form the present-day geopolitical territory known as India. Nonetheless, this dream was shattered when external aggressors in the form of thousands of Hindu extremists backed by RSS entered Jammu on 14th October to ethnically cleanse Jammu of the Muslims. And they succeeded. More than 200,000 Muslims were murdered. 10 days after that, Pakistani tribals entered Kashmir. Realizing his impending doom, the fleeing king requested military help from India and in return acceded the valley into Indian territory temporarily on October 26, 1947, despite the opposition of the people. On October 27, 1947, in the early morning hours, Indian Army landed in Kashmir. Their ascendance led to the start of the occupation, which later led to the movement for Azadi, that is freedom, embroiling the picturesque valley into a conflict. The then Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, after the accession of Kashmir in Indian territory, promised plebiscite to the natives. The promise has not been fulfilled yet by any of the successive administrations. Years later, in 1989, responding to Kashmir's growing militant pro-independence movement, the Indian government decided to militarize the whole valley. The central government implemented the Armed Forces Special Powers Act, AFSPA, giving the Indian Army power to rampage through the resisting valley with impunity. Indian Armed Forces have always legitimized the killings as purging terrorists from the valley, but also foreign elements, basically Pakistani militants, who often cross over into India's Kashmir territory to join the fight against occupation. But in a majority of the cases, innocent Kashmiris are killed with impunity, branded as terrorists or overground workers, that is, supporters of terrorist activities. According to JKCCS, a rights organization based in Kashmir, 528 people have been killed so far this year, including 145 civilians in the occupied valley. And Khurram Parvez, the coordinator of JKCCS, told Al Jazeera that 2018 is the bloodiest year since 2009, when the twin Shopian rape and murder cases by the army resulted in a bloody escalation of conflict, killing 84 civilians. Hiba is an innocent victim of this bloody rampage India has been conducting in Kashmir. Not only killing with impunity, the Indian army has raped with impunity, forcibly disappeared people with impunity, and now blinding Kashmiris with impunity. Coming from the nation that occupies you, I have to say that by no means I'm trying to appropriate your struggles and fights. This video is just in solidarity with you.